There is a misperception exists that the plants are only attacked when they are present in the field. In fact, there are significant number of plant pathogens, especially the fungi and the bacteria, which are capable of causing significant losses in the crops even after the harvest. One of such phytobacterium is known as Erwinia cratovora, which is also known as Pectobacterium cratovorum. This phytobacterium produces the disease which is known as soft rot. Soft rot disease is named after the discharge of liquid from the vegetables such as tomato, potato, bell pepper, cabbage, carrot. The discharge of the liquid is actually due to the bacterium capability of producing cell wall degrading enzymes, which result in the degradation of cell wall, and as well as the discharge of the liquid, which has a foul smell because the bacteria present in it. So in order to evaluate this vegetable against this pathogen, you need to inoculate them after the harvest. Before the harvest, you can just detect the presence of the pathogen, but you can't assess the innate ability of the vegetable against the pathogen. So this can be done with a very simple but a very effective method, which is known as toothpick method. The requirements of this experiments are very simple. You need healthy vegetables, which could be carrot, bell pepper, potato, tomato, etc. But they must be of same size, age, and shape. The second thing is the bacterial culture, but it should not be more than 48 hours old. Along with that, sterilize blunt end toothpicks. These toothpicks are commonly present in every household, and they have sharp ends at both sides. Plus, you need sterilized distilled water as well as incubator or the growth chamber to provide the ideal temperature for the pathogen. So these are the requirements for this experiment to proceed. As I told earlier, this is a very simple experiment. You just need a fresh or a healthy tomato fruit, which is inoculated with the toothpick, which initially dipped in a sterilized distilled water. So this fruit acts as a negative control, and under the ideal condition, it remains free of disease. In another tomato fruit, which is of same size and shape, is inoculated by the toothpick, but that toothpick first was dipped in a bacterial culture, and then it is put into the tomato plant. You can clearly see that there is the destruction of the cell wall and the discharge of the liquid material. In another experiment, the bell pepper is inoculated with a toothpick, but that toothpick is just dipped in a sterilized water, so it acts as a negative control, while when the toothpick, which is dipped in a bacterial culture, is put inside the bell pepper, it resulted in the discharge of liquid material. So this study give you an idea whether the bell pepper or the tomato fruit is resistant or susceptible against the Erwinia cratovora or the Pectobacterium cratovorum. It's a very simple experiment, but it gives you an excellent result and used in different laboratories to assess the virulence of the pathogen as well as the resistance of the vegetable against the pathogen. Only the genetically resistant plant has the ability to stand against the pathogen, while those vegetable which are not genetically resistant will show the soft rot symptom. I hope this video will help you to understand how we can assess the vegetable resistance against the soft rot bacteria.